You see, the last time I spoke about Martin Amidu, I said to him and gave him some useful advice. I said that he should watch DSTV and watch the Premier League. You know, but I think after the Premier League ended, he probably got very bored. So he started writing again, and he's writing stuff that is almost moribund. It's not great for a person who has held such a high political office to be, excuse me to say, reducing himself to some of these things. Do you know the epistle that he wrote about today? Do you know the subject matter of his epistle today? The subject matter of his epistle today is that when he was appointed special prosecutor by President Akufo-Addo, Dr. Dominic Ayini, whom we now know well, former Deputy Attorney General, filed a writ against him that based on his age, he, Martin Benskaiser Alamisi Amidu, was disqualified from holding out himself as the special prosecutor based on his age, that he was over 70 years, which is the age that is allowed within the judicial system for the highest ranking judges, the Supreme Court judges. They retired 70. Dominic Ayini made the point to the Supreme Court and urged on the court to cancel Martin Amidu's appointment and to disqualify him. Now, that action was filed against the Attorney General and as first defendant and Martin Amidu as second defendant. So the Supreme Court looked at the matter and an argument was made that any action brought against the government, and this is essentially an action brought against the president for nominating Martin Amidu as the Attorney General, or against the Attorney General who nominated Martin Amidu pursuant to the act of the Special Prosecutors Act. The Attorney General nominated for the president to appoint. So this action is brought against the Attorney General and by extension the president. So the Supreme Court's attention was drawn to the fact that in such matters where an action is brought against the Attorney General, the Attorney General is the sole defendant of the public office, whatever public office that has been sued. The Attorney General is the sole defendant. So Martin Amidu's name was struck out from the brief that he shouldn't appear in court. That should be good news to the special prosecutor so that he can concentrate on his work, because he had been vetted and he had been passed by Parliament. Can you imagine, viewers, that this is the problem that Martin Amidu is talking about? He sees it as a problem. Now, if you read what he's writing, it's totally shocking. He says that there was a deliberate move to strike him out of the case so that Godfrey Dame, the then Deputy Attorney General, who was arguing the case for the Attorney General, will sort of take his glory. And that when he replied the Dominic Ayini brief, his reply was so good that he filed a supplementary reply, which was also very good. That is he marking himself. Oh, and that Godfrey Dame copied the thing that he filed and he went to the court. And this is what Martin Amidu is talking about. Is it not shocking? You have been sued. The process says that you have been struck out. You don't need to defend yourself. The Attorney General will defend you. And that is Martin Amidu's problem, that they struck me out. And he's seen some conspiracy between the actors, the legal actors in the matter. He's seen some conspiracy over there. I don't know. I think that, to be fair to him, he should calm down and just relax, you know. Sometimes you try to influence people against other people. It doesn't work. You should just leave it and calm down. I mean, those of you who know Martin Amidu, what's my friend's name at CTFM? Umaru Sanda. Journalist Umaru Sanda, you know Martin, and please tell him that he should stop these things. He's embarrassing himself. Is that a matter that you come and tell people of Ghana that, oh, do you remember the case, that case that was done, that Dominic Ayini sued me? Do you remember that the Supreme Court said I should step out of the case? Do you know why? Because Godfrey Dame wanted to take the glory of... Godfrey Dame wanted to take the glory of him. So the Supreme Court said he should be struck out. And that the thing he wrote, the brief he wrote, was so good. He wrote a 13-page brief. The Attorney General's office submitted an 88-page brief. I don't know. A brief is not to be judged in terms of numbers, but the sheer work that has gone into it will indicate how many pages that you filed before the Supreme Court. I'm totally surprised about Benskaiser Amidu. You know, and then he says, as part of this brief, he picks out something that he believes could be a headline, and he says that his main regret is that he trusted Akufo-Addo, that Akufo-Addo wanted to fight corruption. Martin Amidu, please, we beg you. You are our Baba. Don't do this. You came out to tell Ghanaians that Akufo-Addo is the mother serpent of corruption as far as you are concerned, relating to the Japan matter. You came out to say that. You said that even when you were in office as special prosecutor before you resigned. You deliberately said that at the time that election was close. It was your expectation that this will influence Ghanaians against voting for Akufo-Addo in the election. Everybody knows that. Even a first year student of psychology knows that this is what you intended to do. This is your premeditated action. That's what it was. Fair enough. It's a democracy. You put out your letter. It went out. Everybody read it. The Ghanaian people read your letter and they returned a verdict for Akufo-Addo. That is worrying you. We can understand that that is painful. I mean, when you try to influence people, they don't listen to you. It can be painful. We understand that. I mean, people go through that all the time. We understand that. It is the competition, the battle is intellectual. So you try to influence people's intellect. You didn't succeed. You really didn't succeed. I have to say that you failed and you failed woefully because you believed that releasing this story in November was going to hurt the president's fortunes on December 7th. The president came out and won a first round straight victory against John Dramani Mahama of the NDC. Maybe that worried you, but it is okay. As I keep saying, relax, Martin Amidu. Get DSTV. The Premier League is about to start. Never mind that Marcus Rashford missed the penalty in the Euro. He's coming back to play for Manchester United. This time he won't miss penalties. He will score goals. You can enjoy that. If you don't like football, watch Date Rush on TV3. I don't miss that program, you know. Sunday evening, Date Rush on TV3. Martin Amidu, I'm recommending some things for you to keep you busy like a nice grandfather, like a nice baba, laughing and enjoying yourself rather than embarrassing yourself in this way, fighting over something that you have completely lost hold of. Don't do that. You see, when you do that, you begin to reduce yourself, the image of your name among the right-thinking people of our society. Because the right-thinking people of our society know that this Dominica, in any case you are talking about, it's of no consequence to anything right now. You have done your worst. I keep reminding my viewers that there's an important sentence that Winston Churchill made in the Second World War. He told the British people in one of his major broadcasts that, listen, British people, Adolf Hitler will do his worst, but we will do our best. Martin Amidu, you have done your worst. It didn't work. It didn't watch. Nobody listened to you. So stay there. Just watch Date Rush on TV3. Then watch Nanama McBrown's program. I don't miss that either. Entertainment something. What is it called? Somebody should remind me. Showbiz. Showbiz. United Showbiz on UTV. It's by Nanama McBrown. That's Saturdays. You A-plus comes there. You enjoy it. D-Hammer is there. You like it. Mr. Arnold is fighting with Shatawale over there. Shatawale is talking about the cost of some of these shoes. You will enjoy it. I can assure you, Martin Amidu. I watched that program and Abeku Santana is there. It's a great entertainment show. Watch that one Saturday evening. Sunday, watch Date Rush. Tuesday, watch Good Evening Ghana. You have something to say, you can text me. You know my number. I'll read it. But stop this business of I'm writing an epistle to show that I'm the most holy person in the Republic. You were Attorney General for how many years? Deputy Attorney General forever. You became Attorney General. The report is that you wanted to beat up Professor Mills. You're a violent man. The CID should have arrested you. You tried to beat up the president in the castle. We know your history. Don't come and disturb us. The kind of things you filed at the Supreme Court, opposing public demonstrations, we know what you have done. Don't come and disturb us. We respect you, Ababa. We know your history. Don't disturb us. We are fixing our country. We love you. You have done your part. You've played your role. You have done your worst. It didn't work. Watch Date Rush and watch United Showbiz. When the Premier League starts in August, watch Marcus Rashford. He's playing for Manchester United. Watch Thomas Partey. He's Ghanaian. He plays for Arsenal. Arsenal and Manchester United play on the fourth week. I remind you, watch that game. Enjoy yourself. Don't be embarrassing yourself this way, please. Martin Amidu. Okay.